let's go to what's got lurking for us, the problem of the day. Today we have simplify this expression. My goodness, it's quite an expression, isn't it? We're going to try to simplify it down to one number. That's the idea, all the way down, not just leave it in bits and pieces and snips and what have you. But we got 3, and then we've got this big bracket. Inside that, we have 4 minus 2 in parentheses. We're raising that to the 5th power, by the way. That's the exponent, basically exponent symbol that we use nowadays in the technology world. We also have a minus 20, and finally, the end of the bracket. Whew, that's quite a big stuff going on. Plus 4 times 9 minus 3. All right, so let's take a look at this thing. Simplifying the expression, and we're taking all the way down, one number. That's what we're shooting for, all right? I already know some of you people have, out there in Facebook land, have been doing a great job today. Thank you, our viewers, our folks who love Facebook and deal with us there. Already getting rocking and rolling on this problem of the day, so let's just take a look at it. This is all about the order of operations. My dear Aunt Sally, actually, we need to please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, because I see parentheses, I see exponents. I even see brackets. I don't know if we have brackets. I don't know if we have another for B for part of the PB, whatever. But we're going to work inside the brackets, basically acting like major parentheses. All right. So let's go parentheses and exponents, all those kind of things first. So inside the brackets we go, and we do have a parenthesis there. So keep that 3 out there. It's a nice, lovely part of the answer. Don't use it yet. Let's leave it, and let's go to the big brackets here. I see 4 minus 2 in the parentheses, so please excuse, or parentheses and exponents, where we go first. I see 2 to the 5th power. That's what's going on, all right? And we're going to subtract 20, and eventually we'll multiply all that good stuff by, you got it, 3. Now, on the far end down here, I'm going to go ahead and hit the parentheses. We've got 9 minus 3, which should give us 6 last time I checked. Still gives us 6, right, everybody? Everybody says, yes, Ernie, it does. You're on track of it. You're on it today. So we'll multiply that here in just a second. Looking back now into our brackets here, let's work with this. 2 to the 5th is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. It's not 10. My friends, it's not 10. It's not 2 times 5. It's raised to the 5th power. So we'll keep the 3 out there one more time. Inside here, I'm looking at 32. You believe that? 2 times 2 is 4, times another 2 is 8. Woo! And then we go to 2, and we get 16. And then another 2, we're up to 32. That's correct. So that's 2 to the 5th. Let's subtract 20. And over here, why not? Let's just get that 4, 6 out of the way. Let's make that 24. It's going to be out there by itself anyway. We'll save it for the addition at the very, very end now. At this point, you're still inside the brackets, inside the parentheses, so to speak, so let's fix those. That's going to give us a 12, and that's going to be 3 times 12 plus 24. At this point, we have gotten rid of the parentheses. We've gotten rid of the exponents. It's now time to worry about multiplication and division. There's no division hanging out in this problem, but there sure is a nice, sweet multiplication right there. So we're going to take, what is it, 3 times 12, which is 36, and we're going to add 24 to that. Now, at this point, it's just addition, obviously. But like I said, folks, it's the last thing we got to do. The reason we jumped out of line back away here on these subtractions, I jump around, don't I? Yeah, y'all do. And that's why you like me. I take your mind off a few things, and I'll bring you back down to here. But here we had subtraction, but remember, we were inside parentheses. So that's why we did those first. Now we have waited and waited to add 24. We finally get to, I believe your answer is going to be 60. And I recall that we had a few people on Facebook telling me, answer 60, Ernie. And a couple of you were wondering about that little look like a carrot or that little arrow going up with the 5. That meant to the 5th power. You figured it out. You did right on it. So good job to everybody on Facebook. And hopefully got the good answers here. Now, before we lose this one, let's go to the calculator. See how smart your calculator is. Everybody goes, oh my goodness, he's going to go to the calculator. See how smart it is. Yes, we are. So let's put it in here. We got a 3. And I've got brackets. Do y'all know there's brackets on here somewhere? Well, there should be. Where are they? Where are they? Maybe this wasn't my best shot here. I tell you what we're going to do. We're just going to double the parentheses. How's that? So we'll put parentheses, parentheses. And we will put a 4 minus 2 in there. We can handle this. I'm sure there's brackets on here somewhere. I just didn't see them. So someone can call me and write me in there. Keep thinking I still see him, but we're going to go on anyway. We might be here all show waiting for that, and I understand I've got someone waiting to call. So, oh, there's that. Remember how we talked about that little maneuver right there? There's that exponent key, and it's going to actually let us put a real exponent in there. How about a 5? And then we will get out of that one, and we'll come back down here and see if we can't subtract 20. And we'll close the big parentheses. See that? That worked real pretty nice. Now we put a big plus out there. And I go with 4, and I go times parentheses, what about it, 9 minus 3. Unfortunately, this is not going to show us all the little steps. I just wanted to show you that the calculator can do a lot of operations at one time. Let's hit the magic enter button and see if we get 60. We get 60. So guess what? Technology can do it for you. So can we. I think in many cases on a problem like this, it's just as easy to crank it out as much time as it took to type in all those things and wonder, where are the brackets? But anyway, there's your answered problem of the day.